sold out. Scott Field, Starkville, Mississippi. Cam Green has the ball teed at the 35-yard line. The crazies are ready in the stands, those who have painted their bodies and their faces. And you look at Tony James, the SEC's all-time leader in kick return yards. He is joined by Kenny Roberts. Headgear is in the air. State has won the toss, elected to receive. Green has us underway. Short kick. Fair catch is called for and is made at the 23. Tonight they open with Greg Plump. And of course, you know, Sleepy Robinson, the all-everything here, they lost him earlier. Plump is the man who carries the banner for them. The wide receivers, Willie Harris is the go-to guy out of Moss Point, Mississippi. Pros think he's one of the best. And up front, John James is their leader, a senior from Atlanta. He also has done a lot of talking this week, and we'll see if that turns into something. Got a couple of really tough guys to block up there. They're going to throw on first down. Zings it over the middle, incomplete. We'll have to mark them both, Copeland and Curry. The Surgeon General probably should make them wear a warning that says, I can be hazardous to your health. The linebackers, awfully good. Derek Oden, probably the guy instrumental most in making this the number one defense in the country. And George Teague, normally a corner, very versatile. We'll see him at free safety tonight, number 13. Shovel pass. Davis breaks it across the 35 for the no chance of rain. Option play to the open side of the field, and the pitch man going to be knocked down immediately. Hayes, who checks in at tight end, 6'6", 330 pounds, sophomore from New Orleans. A reverse, a counter on the option, hit and caught at the line of scrimmage, John Copeland.
Plants in the game, you might expect him to throw a little bit more.
Third down and 10. Pass, well overthrown. Truitt is the man that he wanted. It's kickers in the country. He leads the Southeastern Conference, and they come after him. Palmer will receive it and is hit immediately at the 32-yard line. Jay Barker out of Trussville, Alabama, will open at quarterback. And at the wide receivers, they don't go deep a lot, but again, David Palmer, they will try to get his hands on the football. Up front, a workman-like offensive line led by Toby Shields at center, a junior from Fairhope. Very smart and very quick at that position. There's Palmer on the very first play. They get him the football. Has five, has 10, has 15, and breaks it all the way out to the 50-yard line. And it was Prince Wimbley.
Against the defense. First down.
Lashing. Will go for maybe 1 yard. Probably the most improved of that down three, Arlie Gibson. And he'll have to be good tonight against the Bama rush. Daniel Boyd, who made the stop just now, the leader of that defensive linebacker unit. And in the secondary, the free safety, Kelvin Knight, a junior from Natchez, tied for the league lead in interceptions. Again, little stutter step, and he'll go inside the 30 to the 29. And short drop, pick out pass, he's caught for the first down, and it's Curtis Brown. Passes with the pitch, runs into his own man, and then gets hit by Mark Woodard. With the pitch, turns the corner, knocked down just inside the 20.
False start, offense, we play the ball.
Nice Gentry making the call, and it's third down Bama. Shovel pass to Lassick. He's got a lot of running room at the 15, at the 10, 5, touchdown Bama. Proctor to attempt the extra point. Knocks it home. And let's take a timeout. And one more look at the shovel pass. Here it is to Lassick. And he will break it right up the middle of the field. And with the blitz having come, nobody home. It's 7-0. Alabama goes on top. Let's take a break. Camp Green to kick it off. Thank you. Randy Brown. Rodney Hudson has come in at quarterback for Mississippi State. He is a freshman out of LaGrange High School. Counter with the action, Kenny Roberts. Good. Lemanski Hall, by the way, you talk about speed. He's a converted strong safety. Now playing at linebacker. Shovel pass. Hit. Knocked down. And this is going to be a loss of five. Wants to throw. And now Hudson running for his life. Throws it. It is intercepted by Teague. And he will be tackled inside the 25-yard line. So the offside penalty is obviously accepted by Mississippi State. Thanks to Michael Davis, wants to put it on his hip, does. Now drills the football and...
Illegal pass against the offense. The fourth down.
They have blocked it. On the ground and touchdown, Alabama. Antonio Langham. We take one more look. That's Langham coming from the outside, or in the middle, actually. There he is, blocks it, picks it up, and 14-0 tied. Again, he's going to push it. And it will come down to the 16-yard line. Again, it's Randy Brown. And Brown will take it out across the 30-yard line. Number 10, Greg Plunk, comes back in at quarterback, the junior from Hattiesburg. Option play to the near side. Turns it up. Has five. And then it's going to be picked up and driven to the turf. It'll be more than interesting to watch. Arizona gets knocked off today after their big upset wins. Big opening in the middle for Davis. We'll take it across midfield. As the Mississippi State coach has said, he has to play well. Again. And breaking the tackle. But this time, number two, it is Prince.
Against this Alabama defense.
Wishbone set for Mississippi State. And they go straight ahead with Michael Davis. Alabama on top. 5 minutes, 35 seconds left, opening quarter. Davis caught for the ankles this time by Michael Rogers. On the first down play. Again, they give the ball to the big quarterback. Lemanski Hall will step up first for the Crimson Tide. Counter with the option, Lemanski Hall to the top of your screen, number 80. Play action, not going anywhere. Lemanski Hall and the blitz.
So he's walking. Good shape off to the sideline.
Chris Gardner to attempt the field goal. This will be an attempt of 42 yards. No good. Off to the right. This past week on top 14-0 in this opening quarter. And it's Lassick who will be hit at the line of scrimmage. Time is back in. It is second down. The Crimson Tide. They need the 35-yard line. David Palmer. And a host of people. And Mike, he's like a water bug. He gets... Third down. Short drop. Pass over the middle is complete for the first down, and it's Prince Wembley. Lass is back up into the middle. Takes it across midfield. About to go under 1 minute in this opening quarter. Little play action. Throws it complete to Lassick. He will cut it back into the middle. And all of that, and I think they picked up the first down. He's not going to make you forget Namath and a couple of other good ones they've had down there. Stable, but he just gets it done. This is Anderson, who's coming to ball game at tailback. He'll have five, and now 10. And I think since that night, they have been on a mission. Anderson again. This time to the left side, as he'll take it to the 25-yard line. And that is the end of the opening quarter. So let's take a break. Here at Starkville at the end of 15. Alabama 14-0. In fact, he'll pick up one that the Bulldogs have. Connor on the reverse. Going to be hemmed in and will fight his way back to the line of scrimmage. Proctor to attempt this field goal as Alabama does not have enough players on the field. They have just gotten enough on. This will be a 42-yard attempt. Not the distance. He's good. Was really unnoticed, but very good. Brown with the return again, and he'll take it back to the 40-yard line.
The way these guys come across the ball, they, you know, beyond the technique and everything, they just love hitting people.
Pitch, and now the long throw downfield, and what? This time, the ball is tipped at the line of scrimmage and still is caught by Truist.
Concentration.
Pressure and straight ahead with Davis. You could see the collision as the ball is loose and Alabama has recovered. George Teague with the recovery.
Are they impressive on defense?
You can really see a lot of bodies flying. Palmer on the reverse. Gets a block from his quarterback, but Woodard trying to chase him down, and he will. Mark Woodard, if it all came in that one drive right at the end of the quarter. Palmer's going to throw it back to his quarterback, and Barker drops it. Probably a good thing. Injured a knee as a freshman, now as a fullback. This is Anderson. At the 40-yard line, out to the 42. Ball is loose, and Mississippi State has recovered. Wants to throw it. Zips it incomplete. Tried to catch it on a shoulder pad. Under the wishbone set. Hunt will go with the option, and he'll have one. Alabama 17, Mississippi State nothing. Looking long, Truett needs to turn around, and it's incomplete. This one does not spiral at all. Palmer with the fair catch. As we mentioned, he did some talking about the Alabama defense earlier this week. And as you see, a good defensive play on Lynch.
You like confidence in your player, but boy, I never like to see that up on another team's bulletin board.
Trip over his quarterback's feet. Third down, and Alabama needs the 21-and-a-half-yard line. Got a man open, and underthrows him. Prince Wembley is who he wanted at the 24. Neal with the kick, and Daniels will get a chance from the 48. Going to be hit just shy of the 35-yard line. A well-coached football team. Play. You see how quickly it closes down. He pitched at exactly the right moment. And it
doesn't look like he's having a lot of fun.
He should be with this team. From the wishbone, they run a counter. Roberts. And he'll be down to the 20-yard line. Game of tonight. 71 yards is what the Tide has given up. Davis will hammer it down to the 17. Second down and long. And here comes Aruski. The guard has picked up the ball, and he's going to be hit right there and knocked down. Bill Sarton. Nope.
Illegal procedure. Offense. The snap was not completed.
Here's the snap. You'll see how he does it. He holds the ball.
That was good.
But I think what happened is he went down and hit the ground. The ball was out. Should have been a good play.
They said the snap was not completed. You could see it came up and hit his hands.
He's to hit for you.
Pass complete Tommy Johnson, a 37-yard field goal. Good pass, plenty of distance, and this time he's good. So Mississippi State is on the scoreboard. It is 17-3.
On target.
Gardner booms it, and this will be 9 yards deep, so not to worry here. Take on the Broncos, 8 o'clock Eastern time. Barker will be sacked at the 16-yard line. Sherman Williams comes in at tailback, number 20. Alabama thinks he's going to be the next really good one there. Rolls, has the pass, and throws it complete. Prince Wembley.
You are going to be in the top five in the nation in football.
Full house backfield this time. And Anderson with the first down. Is
replaced. You have to be happy. You always know where he's at on the field.
He is at the top of the screen. Fumble on the snap, and Barker will make his own recovery. He was split out of Alabama. Barker's pass is well underthrown. Crowd's going to let you know on this one. Third down, and they need the 42. Sacked by Kevin Henry.
Can you throw the football?
Deal with the kick. Wobbly spiral. James will be to the 44-yard line. Straight ahead with Davis this time between Ole Miss and Mississippi State this year. Straight ahead with the carry. That's not going to be enough for the first down. Will not have it. John Copeland is the man who stepped it. Gonna go on top, and he's got Palmer there. Incomplete. Huddle on the far side, discussing what the next plan of attack is. Sherman Wade turns the corner. Look out. He will have the first down. And 39 seconds left until halftime. Alabama from their own 48. And gets it complete to Johnson, or Houston, I beg your pardon, Martin Houston. They don't go downfield. Maybe a reverse to Palmer.
I think you try to throw it downfield, deep downfield.
Looking for him over the middle. Going to go up on top, though. It is tipped and caught at the 4-yard line by Lee. First and goal, Alabama. 7 seconds until halftime.
Or maybe try to throw a fade pass into the corner. One or the other.
Edward Williams tipped the ball.
Umpire standing over the ball will not allow him to snap it. Now he can snap it.
Clock starts and he downs it. 5 seconds.
Good reception.
So Proctor comes on to attempt the field goal. This one 22 yards. And he knocks it home. We are at halftime. And as they head to the locker room, the Alabama Crimson Tide taking advantage of a 46-yard pass completion. It is Alabama 20, Mississippi State 3. The Delta Faucet report is next, right now, this timeout. You look at Palmer. And this kick, not the only way to slow him down, as it goes out of the back of the end zone. Classic on McCarry to open the second half. The pitch to Lashick again, tries to turn the corner. He does, but not enough for the first down. Quick pass intercepted by Mississippi State. That's Charlie Davidson, and he is inside the 10-yard line. Remember, he had the fumble recovery and the only touchdown against Arkansas last week. Option play. Here comes the pitch and hit in the backfield. Teague played it absolutely perfectly.
Got to knock this one in for seven.
Wants to throw it. Zings it. Tip through it. Touchdown. And Mike, as they go for 2 points, they tried to get him again when he transferred from Pitt.
Two shots at him, and he decided to go to Mississippi State on the second try.
Going to throw back with the pass, and has it complete for the 2 points. Clapper.
What an effort by the Mississippi State offense. What a great reception by Landon Truitt.
Mike, how could you possibly fuss at your defensive back? You couldn't cover him any better than that without having defensive pass interference.
Look at that catch, Ron. I'll tell you, that's amazing how he was able to pick that with his one hand, the palm of his hand, and bring it in for the touchdown.
Alabama wanted him, as we said, that they lost him to Pitt. Then when he wanted to transfer, Alabama went after him again and missed him a second time. Johnson on the sideline, and as I said, I really don't think he has anything to be ashamed of.
No, you're right, and I'll tell you, Ron,
tries to go outside. There's Woodard. There's Lassie out of bounds. Lassie hit at the line of scrimmage. Keegan Henry this time. Huge down right here. Third down. The line to make the 30. Throws it. Under throws it. Returnable kick by James. Return to the near sideline. One person broke the wave, and he will be stopped after a couple of yards. Well, then, into the game right now, he probably would be the most outstanding player. Rolls it, has a man wide open, throws it complete to Clanton, and he is inside the 30 to the 25-yard line. As Odin hit him from behind and knocked him into Johnson.
Because he's making spectacular plays. He's having a night.
And roll the pocket. This time it's caught by Harris. 20 to 11. Alabama leads. We are about to go under 11 minutes left in the ball game. Option play, and the pitch comes to McCary. And he will have the Mississippi State first down. First and 10, Mississippi State. With a quarterback keeper. He's at the five. He is at the one. First and goal, Bulldogs. Drives by Mississippi State. First and goal this time. Hit at the one. No arms are up, and he is stopped. Quarterback sneak. Touchdown, Bulldogs. Sherrill's Mississippi State Bulldogs 18. We'll be right back. Only in temperature as far as the weather, but not as far as Mississippi State. Gardner kicks it out of the back of the end zone.
Back on this drive.
They fake the reverse. This is Lashing. Cuts it back up into the middle, and he will have five.
Not allowing Alabama to get the ball and move it, and allowing good field position for their offense.
Pitch comes to Lassie, and he slips down. His knee goes to the ground, but I'm not sure they're leading in momentum right now. Pass is caught. Kevin Lee makes the reception. Sherman Williams comes into the backfield to field that. Gets the carry. Big opening in the middle. Little stutter step, and he'll have it to the 38-yard line.
Tough when you get the other team on a roll, and Mississippi State's on a roll.
Here's the pitch. Williams turns the corner, will be hit, and he'll fight his way back to the line of scrimmage. Rolls the pocket, pumps it once, going to go on top, and he's got him wide open. Caught by Lee, and he drops the football. Oh, my goodness.
On that drop.
Fields a punt, and this is his best of the night. Hanging spiral at the 21-yard line. To the 40, and now to the 44. And we'll see how large that turns out in this football game. Quick looking pass. Intercepted. No, and now this one's dropped. I beg your pardon. Teague had it. Running play. That's a good hit. And second effort is Randy Brown. And third down. The pressure. It's complete. Roberts with the first down and knocks out of bounds. This is Davis. Bounces off one tackler and will be stopped at the 29. They run the option. They force it back inside.
Mississippi State has to also be thinking here on third down. They're in field goal range.
Over the middle. It is caught by the tight end Clapp. Enough for the Bulldog first down. Brown the ball carrier. Randy Brown takes it to just outside the 10. Just comes onto the field of play for Alabama. To the line.
107 yards, Alabama 21.
Flag goes down in the corner and touchdown Randy Brown. Now let's check the marker, which was thrown by the referee behind the offense.
Illegal participation. Offense. Previous spot, 15 yards.
Don't get careless with the football.
They run the reverse. Brown cuts it back into the middle, and he will be stuck at the 14 by Donnelly. Second down. To the 11-yard line is Prince.
Or the run to the fullback.
Looking, drills the pass, and it's well overthrown. Truett, and the field goal attempt. Chris Gardner is going to come from the 17-yard line, so it's a 27-yard attempt. Running a distance, and he's got it. The Bulldogs go on top, 21-20.
Mike DuBose, defensive line coach, going over the adjustment for the defensive line.
Kick is out of the back of the end zone. Pitch goes to Palmer, and they run the reverse. This is Kevin Lee. Blocker in front, and look who's outside. Mark Woodard has been unbelievable tonight. Play action. Looking long, and he's going for Lee. Got him wide open, and the pass is underthrown.
And now being behind, but you still have to find a way to get the ball to number two.
They roll the pocket, pass is thrown. Yes, they say it's a catch at the 32 to Lee.
Well, Jackie's doing a little officiating.
Could be the final play of this third quarter. Takes it to Anderson. Drills the pass, and intercepted by Mississippi State's Charlie Davidson. I don't envy the officials tonight. Boy, there have been some really close plays. That was close to being on the ground, but he caught it. And that is the end of the third quarter. So, we head for the final 15. Mississippi State 21, Bama 20. It will be tipped by Carroll right there at the line of scrimmage, and watch it. Right there, that's on the ground. But he was given the intercept. So it is Mississippi State football.
Kurt Plant. Illegal procedure. Offense.
He is a sophomore out of Montgomery, replacing him. Pressure from the backside, and he is going to be swamped at the 44. Eric Curry, the first man there. We're in the fourth quarter. Mississippi State leading number two Alabama by one. Shovel pass, and it is dropped. That's not a fumble. Everybody scrambles. This is his best kick of the night. Fair catch is called for and is made at the 20-yard line.
You never know. It might be able to put him somewhere.
Sherman Williams breaks off one tackle that is hit by one, two, and three. Jay Barker, the sophomore from Trustville. Under center and a play action. He wants to put it on top. Does and has it complete at the 38-yard line. It's Curtis Brown. Wembley has not lost as a starter quarterback for the Crimson Tide. Over the middle, and again, he is just overthrown at the 49-yard line. Dumps off a short pass. Here's Wembley. And Prince Wembley will take it for the first down. Coming across the middle, and he has Steve Buskey, his tight end.
So keep your eye on Sherman Williams, number 20.
He rolled the pocket, pressure all over. Tries to throw it. It's on the ground. Tipped and recovered by Mississippi State. Let's see if the play is dead or if it's to recover it. Long got on it. But they're going to say dead. That was Daniel Boyd who hit him and knocked the football away. Third down. Play action. Barker will be hit and knocked down back at the 44. That's Stephen Henry.
Mississippi State defense.
Deal with the punt. This is James backtracking. He'll take it from the 16. It's by one. The ball is loose. Picked up by Mississippi State. And he will take it. And now fumbled. And Alabama has recovered at the 43.
He fumbled the football, Ron. Didn't have time enough to put away. Alabama has to go back to run the football here.
Pitch comes to Williams. Tries to turn the corner, gets hemmed in over there by Arlie Gibson.
Something going in. There's a lot on the line for this Alabama and Mississippi State football team.
Puts it into Williams. No place to run. Bounces off one tackle and then will not get by Woodard.
They're running at the ball to David Palmer throwing the ball.
Play action. Looking for Wembley. Got it at the 16-yard line. First and 10, Crimson Tide. Williams caught for the ankles, and he'll fight it to the 13. Arlie Gibson again. Williams inside the 10, down to the 5-yard line.
Between Alabama and Mississippi State defensive line.
Pitch goes to Williams. Can he turn the corner? No. Hit in the backfield, Daniel Boyd.
I just keep figuring they're going to get it to him sooner or later.
Barker back to throw, and that's who he's throwing for. In the end zone, just a little bit too far. Luster had the cover. Looking for the fade route. Corner the end zone. Not close. Kevin Lee is who he wanted.
May have to be the factor that gets you to that opportunity to play for it.
Barker attempting from the 17. Ball is down and he splits it. So we'll take a break. 8-10 left in the ballgame. Our new score, the Crimson Tide 23, the Bulldogs 21. With Mike Gottfried and Adrian Karsten. Wish you could be here in person. This is just, as Mike said, a good old-fashioned get down to the trenches and fight type of football here. James, no place to go, and here comes a late flag.
Pushing it back. Receiving team. half a distance, first down.
See what happens with Alabama on defense, if they change anything in this series.
Mississippi State wants to throw. Pressure is there, gets it off, but it's complete to Roberts, and he will step out of bounds just across the 15. And a very gutsy play as they throw the pass complete, and they move the chains to the 15 and a half. Counterplay, and this one will be stuffed behind the line of scrimmage on the, against the Crimson Tide defense. And here they come with the blitz. Pressure is on. Boy, they're everywhere. And the pass is intercepted by Teague at the 19-yard line.
Well,
the running play will go for one. That's Chris Anderson. And he, 23-21. Alabama on top. Again, they go with the running play. Anderson, just the little hole, squeezes through, has the first, and it is first and goal at the 6-yard line. Derek Lassett, right side, hit at the 5, and he'll fight it to the 3. Jimmy Miles. That's Anderson. He will take it to the 1-yard line, and now they're going to say inside the 1. Straight tee. Anderson over the top, touchdown Crimson Tide. Points, Alabama. And he does. 30-21 with 5:13 left in the ball game. Pooch it. They don't want to kick it to James. So Green puts it high in the air, and this is Galloway. Galloway will take it to the 31-yard line. Gets it away and has it complete. His tight end Clinton, but he will be stopped at the 37.
What happens to the off? I'll give it to you in a second with Gary Curry.
Draw play. Davis, you could see him run into his own man and knock him forward. On third down, being hit, the ball is tipped, and that was Antonio London. Watson Brown, what will the fourth down call be? Needs a couple. Pressure, pass is batted down at the line of scrimmage, and it's Albert Brown. Line. This is, guys, in case you have to go back in the lineup. Martin Houston with a rare carry.
And he, they got a physical football game here tonight.
Yeah, they really did. About to go under 3 minutes left in this one. Karen Lynch, he will be gang tackled and pushed back. Keep it on the ground, and that will be enough for the Alabama first down.
He's fired up, ready to go for that one.
Anderson hit by Woodard and knocked down. It appears as though they're going to win, but boy, they got as big a scare as they had all year long. A legitimate scare. Anderson bounces in. Back out and then back in again. We'll have a close ball game in the second half. You'd have taken it because you wouldn't have thought it. Not the way Alabama dominated the first 30. Do you think?
No, I'll tell you, Mississippi State just really...
Well, the longest winning streak that Alabama's ever had was 28, and Mississippi State broke that back in 1980. Had a chance to repeat history, but it's not going to be true tonight. As Palmer, minute 17 seconds left, as State will take over the ball. Caught by Truett, and he will be pushed out of bounds. Pass underthrown, and that'll how quickly they can get rid of this one, because Ole Miss is a very good football team who secured a Liberty Bowl berth today. That ball is caught inside the 40.
Ready to go, because those two games will be exciting.
Pass is thrown complete. Willie Harris, and he will go out of bounds. Pass is going to be underthrown. It was Willie Harris. Is tipped and it's caught at the 11-yard line. Willie Harris makes the reception.
Get it in the end zone right now.
Pressure from the outside. Pumped once. Now in the end zone, ball is tipped and George Teague comes up with the interception, and that will do it with 28 ticks left on the clock.
Frustrated Johnny Majors, of course. We all know the news at Tennessee.
So now, the Alabama Crimson Tide in the championship game, the first ever SEC championship game as a two-division race. And who would it be, the Florida Gators or